This is Unit 6, Lesson 4 for 8th grade Algebra 1. In this lesson, we're going to learn how to construct and analyze two-way tables. So we're going to be looking at how to construct and analyze two-way tables. The application here is data analysis, a collection of information, and then being able to analyze and interpret it, which is a very important real-world skill. Categorical data is data that can be broken up into groups. For example, gender, race, eye color, flavors of ice cream. There are different types within each group. So here's a two-way table. Two-way tables typically will compare sort of two different pieces of information. So here we have sports, and we have what school level they're in, elementary, middle school, and high school. And in this table, it's a frequency table because it's telling me how many students were in that particular category. So there are 27 people who chose baseball as their favorite sport who are in the elementary school. There are 8 middle school students who chose basketball as their favorite sport. Then you can see that for each row and each column, we also receive the total that was in that category. So, for example, there are 57 elementary students that were talked to, 54 middle school, and 89 high school. You can see that there were 50 students altogether that chose basketball as their favorite sport. So, frequency tables tell me how many there are for that category. Now, those values can be turned into percents. What percent of something was in that group? So there are different ways that you can make those percents. So the percents can either come from the entire table, what was the whole total, or they can come from the rows or columns. And the relative frequency, the total for that row or column or overall, will be 1. So we're not going to write percents, but we'll leave the values as decimals. So here we have an example based on frequency. We looked at 50 eighth graders and surveyed what type of ice cream and topping sort of combination that they like. So we have 30 students chose vanilla, 20 students chose strawberry, and then you can see you can add those together to get my 50. So this is a frequency table. It's telling me how many there were for each one. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take this frequency table and we're going to turn them into percents. Now, the percents in this situation are going to be based off of the total. So, for example, this right here, 100% or 1 is going to represent all of the students. Well, what percentage of the students liked sprinkles? So that would be this box right here. Well, we have 16 out of 50. So if I want to change that into a percent, there was 16 out of 50. And so that would be 0.32 or 32%. But again, we're going to leave them as decimal values. What percent chose chocolate chip? Well, that's 17 out of 50. And so that gives me 0.34. How many chose nothing for their topping? So that was also 17 out of 50, which is the same as the previous, 0.34. Now, if you notice, if I add these three together, that gives me the total 100%. And if you think about it, that makes sense. Then I'm going to fill in the rest of the boxes here. So how many people like vanilla and sprinkles? Well, that was 9 out of the total of 50. Because again, we're basing our percents off of how many people there were all together. And you'll see in the next two tables why they're going to look a little bit different. So we got 9 out of 50. So we divide that out, or if you know how to convert that into a decimal using a shortcut, we get 0.18. For strawberry and sprinkles, they said there were 7 out of 50. So that gives me 0.14. And if you notice, if I add these two boxes together, I get the one down on the bottom. Which makes sense. The vanilla plus the strawberry with sprinkles should equal all of the sprinkles. For chocolate chip, you get 8 out of 50, which will give me 0.16. And for strawberry and chocolate chip, we get 9 out of 50, which will give me 0.18. Again, if I add the two chocolate chip boxes together, that gives me the total chocolate chip. For nothing as a topping, we have 13 out of 50, and that gives me for the vanilla ice cream, and that gives me 0.26. And then we have 4 out of 50 for strawberry with nothing to give me 0.08. Again, if I add these two boxes together, I get the total down below. And because these values are based off of the total, when I add across the row, that will give me the same thing as 30 out of 50, which is 0.6, and 20 out of 50, which is 0.4. So these two boxes add together to give me the 100%. And going across the row, 0.14, 0.18, 0.08 will give me 0.4 when I add them up. So that's how you can convert a frequency table into a relative frequency table where the total represents 100%. So now we're going to base our 100% off of the rows. So a relative frequency based on the rows. So that means my 100% represents these right here. They're all going to be 1. Notice these don't add together to give me 1 like they did on the last table. So what's happening here is that these three boxes will add together to be the 100%, 100% vanilla, 100% strawberry, and then the totals on the bottom. So when I'm writing my fractions here to calculate my decimals, my numerator for vanilla with sprinkles is 9, but my denominator here is going to be 30 because that's how many people chose vanilla overall. I'm basing my 100% off of how many people were in each of the rows. So there are 30 people in that row, 20 in this row, and 50 in the bottom one. So we end up getting, now we'll end up rounding here a little bit. So I got 9 divided by 30, and that gives me 0.3. If we need to round, we will. So on the next one, then, we get 8 out of 30 for the chocolate chip with vanilla. And so 8 divided by 30 gives me, now we'll round to two decimal places, so 0.27. And then for the last one, for nothing, we have 13 divided by 30. Since 13 people chose vanilla ice cream with nothing. And that is approximately, again, we're going to round here, 0.3. And notice that if I add these three percents together, that I would end up with one whole. So we'll do the same thing with the strawberry. Now, the strawberry only has 20 people chose strawberry. So we have 7 out of 20. 9 out of 20, and 4 out of 20. So if I convert these into decimals, I get 0.35, 0.45, and 0.2. And when I add them all up, I would get 1, which is the total for strawberry. And then for the last one, I get 16 out of 50. Which gives me 0.32. I get 17 out of 50, which gives me 0.34. And then 17 out of 50 again, which gives me 0.34. So again, notice that up and down, the numbers don't really correlate because they're based off of these totals, the 30, the 20, and the 50. But going across the rows, which is what this problem is about, they match up and add to give you the total or 1. So 0.3 plus 0.27 plus 0.43 will give you 1 whole. On the bottom there, 0.32 plus 0.34 plus 0.34 will give you 1. The last way we can make our table is based on the columns being the total. So my totals for my columns are 16, 17, 17, and 50. And so for the first one, vanilla with sprinkles, we're saying, okay, what percent of people who chose sprinkles also wanted vanilla? So that's 9 out of 16. And so I change that into our decimal form. And again, we're going to round, so we have 0.56. For strawberry and sprinkles, we get 7 out of 16. So 7 divided by 16 gives me 0.43. And then for the bottom, we have 16 out of 16, so that's my whole, that's 1. And so since I'm basing it based on the columns, these are going to be the ones this time. Then we have chocolate chips and vanilla. Well, that's going to be 8 out of 17. And for the strawberry and chocolate chips, that's 9 out of 17. So we'll get those both converted. So we get 0.47 and 0.53. And again, these are rounded, and so when I add those together, I do get 1. Then for not having any topping, that was 13 out of the 17 people would choose vanilla without any toppings, and 4 out of 17 chose strawberry without any toppings. And so those turn into 0.76, and for the other one, I get 0.24. And again, these add together to give me 1. And then for the last column, we get 30 out of 50 and 20 out of 50, giving me 0.6 and 0.4, which does add together to give me 1. So in the last three slides, we looked at how do I can convert a frequency table into a relative frequency table, and why those numbers are the way they are. Where their ones are, and why are they there, and what does that mean as far as how those values are calculated? Then, when you're working on your homework, which is going to be computer work, you will answer questions about these different types of tables where the numbers have been filled in. So, for example, here's a frequency table, and we'll answer a couple questions. So, we have a two-way table that shows the number of students who voted for two candidates for school president by grade. And so you can see that Kiera got some votes from the seventh graders and the eighth graders. Cassie got some votes from the seventh graders and eighth graders. And then they tell me how many of each grade level voted for each. And then there are 155 votes altogether. So the first question says, how many more eighth graders voted for Cassie than Kiera? So we're only talking about the eighth graders. So eighth graders for Kiera, eighth graders for Cassie. How many more voted for Cassie? Well, what's the difference between 60 and 20? Well, that would be 40. So there's 40 more votes for Cassie than Kiera. How many less eighth graders voted for Kiera than seventh graders who voted for Cassie? So we got to find which numbers we're talking about. So we're talking about eighth graders who voted for Kiera. So eighth graders and Kiera, that's 20. And then we have seventh graders who voted for Cassie. Seventh graders and Cassie. So how many less eighth graders? Well, what's the difference between 30 and 20? Well, that would be 10. So 10 less eighth graders, and we'll abbreviate here a little bit, voted for Kiera. Then seventh graders for Cassie. So here we have another table. We're looking at cars and SUVs, and then what color that the dealership has and how many. So which is the least popular color for the car? So here are the cars, and here are all the car colors. Which one was the least popular popular. Well, that'd be the one that has the lowest number. And that's white. What is the most popular color for SUV? So here's the SUV. Which one is the most popular? Well, it looks like the one that is the highest is blue. So blue is the most popular. And then how many more green cars are there compared to white SUVs? So white SUVs and green cars. Well, there'd be 10. So 10 more green cars compared to white SUVs. So in this lesson, we just sort of looked at how do you write and convert two-way tables, and we answered some questions. And the best way to really work and analyze and work with and do this type of a lesson is just to jump right into it. So in class, we're going to be working on the computer and looking at different examples, and you're going to try them on your own. So this completes the lesson. You are now ready to begin the work.